Hello, everybody. This is SharkRay24, and I would like to thank you again for joining me on this dramatic reading episode for February 2020. So, if you don't know what February is, it just started this year. If you follow any big artists on Tumblr or Twitter, you've probably heard of Mermay, where for the entire month of May, artists are challenged to draw as many mermaids as they can. And February is basically the same thing, but for fairies. And I love fairies! Tinkerbell is my favorite Disney character. I just love fairies a lot. You know, just because they're cool. So I thought I'd make my own contribution to the very first February by doing some dramatic readings. Firstly, I want to say thank you to the artists whose art is in the thumbnail. I will be thanking them individually at the end of the video. So make sure you stick around for that so you can go follow them for their absolutely amazing artwork. They're just so amazing. Anyways, this dramatic reading is going to be containing three monologues from A Midsummer Night's Dream, because that's my favorite Shakespeare play. So four different monologues from A Midsummer Night's Dream. They're all Puck's monologues. And then there's going to be a different poem in between each of those monologues. And I will be making sure to say, you know, who the poem's by when I start it, just like I did with the Valentine's Day episode. But for the Puck monologues, I'm just gonna say Midsummer Night's Dream, Act 2, Scene 1, etc. Anyway, without further ado, let's dive into this February reading. A Midsummer Night's Dream, Act 2, Scene 1, by William Shakespeare. Thou speakest aright. I am that merry wanderer of the night. I jest to Oberon and make him smile, when I a fat and bean-fed horse beguile, neighing in likeness of a filly foal, and sometime lurk I in a gossip's bowl, in very likeness of a roasted crab, and when she drinks, against her lips I bob, and on her withered dewlap pour the ale, the wisest aunt telling the saddest tale. Sometime for 3-foot stool mistaketh me, then slip I from her bum, down topples she, and Taylor cries, and fall into a cough, and then the whole choir hold their hips and laugh, and waxen in their mirth, and knees and swear, a merrier hour was never wasted there. But room, fairy, here comes Oberon. The Wind on the Hill, by Dora Sigerson. Go not to the hills of Erin, when the night winds are about. Put up your bar and shutter, and so keep the danger out. For the good folk whirl within it, and they pull you by the hand, and they push you on the shoulder, till you move to their command. And lo, you have forgotten what you have known of tears, and you will not remember that the world goes full of years. A year there is a lifetime, and a second but a day, and an older world will meet you each morn you come away. Your wife grows old and weeping, and your children one by one grow gray with nights of watching before your dance is done. And it will chance some morning you will come home no more. Your wife sees but a withered leaf in the wind about the door. And your children will inherit the unrest of the wind. They shall seek some face elusive, and some land they never find. When the wind is loud, they sighing, go with hearts unsatisfied, for some joy beyond remembrance, for some memory denied. And all your children's children, they cannot sleep or rest, when the wind is out in Erin, and the sun is in the west. A Midsummer Night's Dream, Act 2, Scene 2. Through the forest I have gone, but Athenian found I none, on whose eyes I might approve this flower's force and stinging love. Night and silence, who is here? Weeds of Athens he doth wear. This is he, my master said, despised the Athenian maid, and here the maiden sleeping sound on the dank and dirty ground. Pretty soul, she durst no lie near this lack love and kill courtesy. Churl, upon thy eyes I throw all the power this charm doth owe. When thou wakest, let love forbid sleep his seat on thy eyelid. So awake when I am gone, for I must now to Oberon. The Lorelei by Heinrich Heine and translated into English by Ernst Fies. I do not know what haunts me, what saddens my mind all day. An age-old tale confounds me, a spell I cannot allay. The air is cool, and in twilight the Rhine's dark waters flow. The peak of the mountain in highlight reflects the evening glow. There sits a lovely maiden above so wondrous fair, with shining jewels laden she combs her golden hair. It falls through her comb in a shower, and over the valley rings a song of mysterious power that lovely maiden sings. The boatman in his small skiff is seized by a turbulent love. No longer he marks where the cliff is. He looks to the mountain above. I think the waves must fling him against the reefs nearby. And that did with her singing the lovely Lorelei. A Midsummer Night's Dream, Act 3, Scene 2. My mistress, with a monster, is in love. Near to her, close and concerted bower, while she was in her dull and sleeping hour, a crew of patches, rude mechanicals, that work for bread upon Athenian stalls, were met together to rehearse a play intended for great Theseus' nuptial day. The shallowest thick skin of that barren sort, who Pyramus presented in their sport, forsook his scene and entered a break, when I did him at this advantage take. An ass's knoll I fixed upon his head. Anon his Thisbe must be answered, and forth my mimic comes when they him spy, as wild geese that the creeping fowler eye. Or russet patched coughs many in sort, rising and cawing at this gun's report. sever themselves and madly sweep the sky. So at his sight, away his fellows fly. And at our stamp, here o'er and o'er, one falls. Fairy Eyes, an original poem by Sharkray 24. Her eyes are drawing me in, into the land of youth and fairy lights. Come with me, follow me this way. My child, I have been watching you since you were born. I know the things you have seen, and I know you desire the truth. Won't you come with me and find what you've been looking for? I looked at her in awe, this mysterious fairy woman, speaking to me from within my dreams. Was she telling me the truth? Did she know who I really am? I have been seeing these fairies for a long time, ever since I was a child. They'd smile at me and laugh with me and sing to me their sweet songs. But as I got older, the darkness came too, and with it all forms of torment. I never knew why this was happening, but could she answer my questions? Do I dare take her hand? A Midsummer Night's Dream, Act 5, Scene 1. If we shadows have offended, think but this, and all is mended. That you have but slumbered here, while these visions did appear, and this weak and idle theme, no more yielding but a dream. Gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend. And as I am an honest puck, if we have unearned luck, now to scape the serpent's tongue, we will make amends ere long. Else the puck a liar call, so good night unto you all. Give me your hands, if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends. Hello, everybody! This is Sharkray24 again, wanting to thank all of you for watching this video that I know is a bit longer than the dramatic reading that I did for Valentine's Day. But, you know, this is only the second one, so I haven't really figured out how long, on average, I want these videos to be. So, as promised, I need to go through these wonderful works of art, one by one, and thank every single artist who made all these pieces. So, firstly, upper right-hand corner, that little Navi, I made that. So, thanks me. Bottom right-hand corner, I've already thanked them in my channel update back in January of 2020, but I want to thank them again because they did a freaking amazing job with it, making my fairy mascot for the YouTube channel, Rook Jones, showing them some of their other art right now, you know? They're on Twitter! And they're gonna have commissions open soon, I believe, so go follow my friend and make sure you commission them if you're able to. Alright, coming up next on that top left, actually no, we're gonna do the bottom left first. We're gonna do the bottom left one. Okay, bottom left. Credit for that one goes to artist Ruhiana, gonna be linking her Tumblr and her Twitter down in the description, showing off some of her work right now. She is absolutely amazing. I've commissioned her plenty of times before. I should warn you, though, if you go follow her, you should know that she is on the top most wanted list by the cutie police because her art is so darn cute, it's been known to kill. I'm joking, but no, seriously, her art is great. Go follow her. Yeah. And then, finally, on the top left corner, is a very close friend of mine. I want to thank my good friend, who is one of the first friends I ever made on the internet. Favorinim, I believe is how she wants it to be pronounced. I don't know, because she changed the username recently. It used to be something else. I'm not going to say it in case she doesn't want other people to know. But yeah, I'm going to be linking her Tumblr in the description. She's great. She's amazing. She lives in Australia, and currently they're on fire, and I worry about her every day. But she's amazing. So there's actually a story behind that little fairy character. When I first met her, we decided to do an Ask blog together around this little fairy character named Imelda. And we found that it was very hard to keep up an Ask blog when you live on opposite sides of the globe and you almost never get to talk to each other because time zones suck. So we ended up not going through with it. We ended up dropping it, but Imelda's still important to both of us, so I like to stick her in wherever I can. So that's the little story behind that. And Faye, if you're watching, I hope you are. Love ya. You're great. Please don't catch on fire. With that, this video is done. I had a really fun time doing it. I hope you all enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed doing it, because Midsummer Night's Dream, as I said in the intro, is my favorite Shakespeare play of all time, and Puck is one of my favorite Shakespeare characters of all time. I love them. Shakespeare really went out and made one of the best non-binary characters of all time. Yeah, Puck's non-binary. Deal with it. Anyway, so yeah, Puck's one of my dream roles, so it was very, very fun to do all of those. So anyway, I've rambled on in this outro long enough, so I'm gonna let the end card roll now. Bye-bye.